My next guest is Sahara boss Subroto Roy, who's in a bit of trouble. In fact, that's an understatement. One of India's leading business tycoons. He has interests from finance to real estate, Bollywood, of course, and cricket. Very high-profile man. He's juggled all kinds of various ventures, but today he has faced some very uncomfortable questions from market regulator SEBI over a 24,000 crore rupee case. The Supreme Court is also examining the case. It's very tough times for Subroto Roy, who's my last guest on the News Hour tonight. Mr. Subroto Roy, first question is that you say you have refunded 4 crore investors. And you have said that you have sent more than truckloads of documents to the Securities and Exchange Board of India's headquarters. But there's a huge controversy, Mr. Roy. SEBI says all these people who you claim as your investors are all fake, that they are not real.
Well, SEBI says so, but it is totally wrong on their parts to say so. We had in the newspaper also had very challengingly said that no, every investors are totally right, authentic investors. And not a single fictitious account our investors are there. There's nothing fake about it.
Mr. Subroto Roy, you are one of the richest people in India. I'm surprised you're making it a rich man, poor man argument. You say that a rich man, SEBI, does not understand and does not recognize poor investors. Coming from a very rich man, it seems strange. Why are you making this a rich man, poor man debate? It's not about that. It's about regulation.
The point is, we are probably the only company in the country, including public sector, who are reaching to crores of such people, small people, where neither bank reaches nor they go to banks. I think we are the right example of financial inclusion, which nobody is recognizing. And crores of people have all the faith on us last 35 years. And I tell you, we have gumtis in the highways, chaiwala and rickshawala, all kind of cobblers. And they have transformed their life with us. A rickshawala who was pulling a rickshaw on hire is owning 2-3 rickshaws. A cobbler has become a big fruit vendor. So these people are such people nobody is recognizing. That's why I'm saying that yes, one should recognize these investors, these people who invest 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, 5,000, 7,000, 10,000 rupees.
You are making it you are trying to make it a popular argument. But Mr. Roy, let's be on the basics. SEBI says it wrote to 20,000 sample depositors, asking them to apply for a refund. Only 68 wrote back. That is well below 1%. Therefore, the question is, on facts, Mr. Subroto Roy, if these are real depositors, should they not have written back when they are being offered a refund, unless they are fake?
No. I tell you, first thing, SEBI should have contacted us also as per the Supreme Court order. Well, forget that. Now tell me one thing. The persons, small persons, who have got back their money, why should they respond to the SEBI's letter? Why should they spend 5 rupees extra to that? It is a very simple thing to understand. They will never come because they have been repaid before 31st August. All the payments were done before the judgment came from the Supreme Court. So why should anybody expect? This is a simple thing to understand. The small investors will never respond to their letter who have got their repayments. They will not spend even a rupee for that.
You are basically putting this whole argument out, Mr. Roy, that you are a victim. Why would you be the victim? Why would the system collude against you? Who have you upset? Now the Supreme Court will be hearing a plea by SEBI seeking orders for your arrest and barring you from leaving the country. Are you worried? You are putting out advertisements. you have made this a whole issue of, you know, nationalism. You painted yourself as a person, you know, who might be in a tight corner, but who represents the values of this country, etc. How can you fight back? At this point of time, the facts seem to be loaded against you.
It is total huge ego problem from 2008 we are facing, rather 2005 we are facing. And 2008 is the outcome of that also. Let us not go into details, then you have to probably listen to me for half an hour. I'll definitely come back to you whenever you like. I will come back to the details also. And it is all out of false ego and vengeance, nothing else. We have not done anything wrong. And I can tell you, Arnabhai, I, with full confidence I'm telling you, nobody on this earth can prove right as wrong. Nobody can do that. A time will only say that.
Well, it's not an easy situation to be in for sure. Subroto Roy, thank you very much for talking to me on NewsHour Direct.